Hey guys, it's Josh, and welcome to my new Let's Play of Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agents. Now, you may remember that I did a preview of this one several months ago before before my Little Nightmares is LP. Jeez, was that really only to be a viewer a couple years ago? Wow. Anyway, that was just a preview to get things sorted, so... Well, I've actually been really looking forward to this one for a while now. It's a fun game, and... I don't feel like it gets enough attention, so... Fingers crossed that you guys enjoy this one as much as I do. Let's get started. Well, that can only mean trouble. Okay, so, simple enough, you really cannot fail this one, like, at all. Simply match the letters Oh, hi Jonas. There. That one. That one. And that one. Again, this is really the only puzzle you cannot solve, and you cannot possibly fail. So... Well... It's simple enough that you cannot fail it anyway, so... Or that you shouldn't be able to sort of fail it. Yay! So, I will be showing you how to get at the top agent rank on every single puzzle. There are a total of 37 puzzles. So this should be fun.
Puzzle research. This is Agent Tethers. I think you have the wrong number. Oh, I see. An assignment. In the field? No, sir. It's been. Yes, quite some time. Uh-huh. Erasers? The foundation of democracy? Oh, absolutely, sir. I agree, sir. Oh, yes, the White House needs its erasers, sir. I'll be on the next plane to... Wait, where? Just arrived in Scoggins, Minnesota. Population, 754. Temperature, it's cold, and not much to look at. According to the agency, there's some kind of thing going on at the local eraser factory. The whole plant is shut down. There's a weird man staring at me. Hopefully, this won't be a big waste of time. Agent Tethers out. I have no idea where my hotel is. I might have to ask for directions.
All right, let's talk to Bjorn.
Excuse me, I'm Nelson Tethers with the FBI's Department of Puzzle Research. Hello?
Yep.
Okay, and you are?
Bjorn.
Bjorn?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Bjorn. Boy, those snowmobiles sure are a bumpy ride, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Can you give me directions to the nearest hotel? I'm having a little trouble finding my way around.
You'd never get there. Roads are too slick.
Sir, I am an agent of the FBI's Puzzle Research Division. It can't be harder than the puzzles I see every day.
Not so.
It's really just a matter of trajection.
Okay, on the way to the hotel, you're going to pass two traffic lights.
Simple enough. So, this one. As you can see, there are some logs already on the map. Those ones cannot be moved at all. There are two possible ways of solving this particular puzzle. You can either create a Z shape or an N. That is one option, and by placing one log there and the other up there, or you can place one here, and then one here. Forcing Nelson to go in a Z shape. Keep movement. So bouncing from that tree, he tried because he hits this side. It's there, it's there, it's there, and there, passing both traffic lights. That's the one I'm going with. But you can personally go with, but you personally can go with whichever one you want. I mean, technically it's an S this shape and not a Z shape, but close enough. Well, that was easy.
I must have gotten lost. I thought your directions were taking me to the hotel.
They did.
I'm standing in front of the hotel, aren't I?
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
Welcome.
Seen any suspicious people hanging around the hotel lately?
Yep.
Really? Can you describe them?
Skinny asks lots of questions. There's a stupid hat.
Thanks for the tip.
Yep.
I'm here to investigate an incident at the Scoggins Eraser Factory. Do you know anything about it?
Nope. The hotel's going to close soon. You better check in if you're sticking around.
Covered a fence. Boards all chewed up something terrible. Could be the work of strays trying to get to the dumpsters back there. I don't know why I'm recording this. Some Tethers. I have a reservation.
Oh yeah, you'll hear about the Eraser Factory, eh? We're awfully excited to have a real FBI man in our town. It's just like TV, yeah? Ooh, I'm gonna make some hot dish for you later.
A hot dish?
Oh, you'll love it. I've never met a man who didn't love himself some hot dish.
What room am I in?
Yeah, okay, I've got your room right here. Oh dear, this is so embarrassing. The night clerk wrote down your room number in code.
Mind if I have a look? I bet I can figure out what room I'm in.
Okay, so You're looking at the this case, you want to look at the negative space. So, basically the space between the lines. N-I-N-E. Whether you put this in as 09 or just 9, it doesn't matter. Gets you the same response. Click submit. And we're done. Well, that was gross. You can use his gum to get hints, but it is not something I personally would be doing. In this case, I remember we had a little bit of trouble with this particular puzzle during the preview, and it turned out that it was this one. I believe. Yes, this one. Okay, and
excuse me, you look perplexed.
Let's help this guy out.
So many puzzles. Puzzles? I might be able to help you with that.
Oh, this one. yes, see. I am definitely familiar with this one. Okay, so those who are correct is that one. That one should be correct like that. That one's correct anyway. So is that one. That's also correct. That one's definitely correct. And let's submit that.
Solved. Now maybe you can relax a little.
With the whispers. An acrostic or enigma leads to Baltimore trans deletion. The whispers?
Or not?
You know what? Before we head off to, let's see. Oh yes, and as you can see here, we have a complete list of all the and all the puzzles we've have played. along with Nelson Tethers' field journal. Main menu is over this way. We didn't really need to do that yet.
Someone left a screwdriver in the alley beside the hotel. Looks clean. Probably of no consequence.
Let's have a look at this. This here.
Winner undeclared in local contest.
So, logic puzzle type style competition. Another optional puzzle. So this is our third optional puzzle out of six that we've done so far. See, what the puzzle itself does not mention is that it's a single elimination style tournament. So, four contestants, two rounds. Each contestant it was in either one or two. Two of them, obviously. Contestants 3 and 4, these two, as their statements indicate, they were defeated. It so cannot have won. She, the contestant, hang on. Wait, those are contestants 1 and 2. These are 3 and 4. That is contestant 3, who must be Flo. Oh, for the grizzly grip, which means that must be Pearl. So, the winner yes, to solve this, note that the grizzly grip is, or it was, both a winning and a losing technique. Meaning it was in both rounds, but the person using it lost in the second round. Since these are the only two we're talking about, out winning, and these two are both talking about the grizzly grip being someone and being another person's technique. She must be a Flo with the grizzly grip, which means this contestant here is contestant number 4, Pat, and is the winner.
That was a tricky one.
Well, right, I think we have enough time to head out to...
The residents of Scoggins seem nice enough. Aside from one wild goose chase, everyone's been cooperative. Plus, it looks like I'm primed for all the hot dish I can eat. It remains to be seen if that's a good thing. I got a map from the hotel owner, so I'm heading over to the eraser factory. Agent Tethers out. Am I supposed to be saying that?
Right, onto the snowmobile. Wow.
Hi, Sheriff Bob. Yeah, I'm Nelson Tethers of the FBI's Department of Puzzles.
Agent Tethers, good to meet you. We got a real mess here. Yes, we do.
We do?
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a while before we can get this factory running again.
But my job is to get this factory back to making erasers.
Agent Tethers, you're in a right pickle.
Well, I should probably ask you some questions about the incident, then.
That's what I'd do if I was a big, important FBI boy.
Okay.
What was this incident?
Well, we don't need to be dramatic.
What happened?
There was an explosion.
What?
Oh, yeah. A big explosion. And the foreman just never came home.
What happened to the foreman? My notes don't have a lot of details.
Well, we're still trying to figure that out. One day after work, Mr. Dabner just never came home. The accident was pretty bad.
Oh, is there a body?
No, he's just gone. Isaac Dabner's his name, if you don't have that in your notes.
We don't even know if he died in that explosion?
Won't be able to find that out till we find a way into the factory.
What did your investigation turn up?
Not much. I can't figure out how to get past this lock.
Well, that's because it's missing a piece. I can see that just by looking at it.
So it is. I guess that's why you make the big bucks, right?
That's right, sir. When did the accident take place?
Well, I've been trying to figure that out myself. Here's what I know.
Alright, so the big noise, I guess, would be the explosion. So, let's have a look. Interesting. Okay, so. Okay, so, what happened. Okay, so we've got Bernie, Pop, Al, and Iggy. As you can see here, obviously. Okay, so Iggy's statement implies that he worked from six. It says that he worked from six until he was relieved. So he was. Is relieved by another guard. Now, Pop can't have been on the first shift. If before or Iggy, because he, and according to his statement, his is only 3 hours. So, and we know he can't be the third at shift. Because that's what a Bernie's statement is implying. So, since Al didn't do 8 hours, obviously, according to his statement, he must have done 6 hours, from 12 a.m. to 6 a.m. Which means Pop did as 9 p.m. through to 12 a.m. and Bernie 1 p.m. through 2 the explosion at 8.
If there was an explosion at that time, wouldn't the icicles on the building have been knocked off?
Good point. Maybe they grew back.
Well, I don't seem to be getting a lot of answers.
Listen, why don't you meet me down at the Moonseer Diner later? I have some files related to the case that you might be able to help me with.
Oh, okay, but I really think...
Agent Tethers, it's a pleasure working with you. Doing a great job. Meet you at the Moose here in a bit.
Interesting. Out at their eraser factory. The doors to the factory are very locked. Some sort of custom-built contraption has got this place locked up tighter than Fort Knox. The device seems damaged, though. It seems to be missing a piece.
Right, well, you know what we're going to do? We are going to end things off here. And then next time on Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent, we're going to head head to the Moosehead Diner and meet up with the sheriff. So, if you have enjoyed the video, a like rating is very much appreciated. Hit the subscribe button down below to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have subscribed but you haven't been receiving notifications, then click the bell icon down below next to the subscribe button, of course, to make sure that you don't miss any notifications for videos in the future. Share the video with your friends. Leave a comment down below. And my Facebook, Twitter, and Discord information is, as usual, in the description box down below. Alright, with that done, I'll see you guys next time for another episode of Nelson Tethers Puzzle Agent. Until then, Josh, out.